we are. We're camping up at the top of La Sambuy, and for tonight's episode, we're going to review our respective adventure meals. Mincek, start us off.
It was beautiful at the top of the hill, but one thing it wasn't was flat. There was only one small area right by the top of the chairlift, but at least it was sheltered from the wind. It was chilly up there, but the views looking north over Lake Annecy were stunning. And when it got dark, the stars were incredible.
Day six of our little volbiv adventure. And it's looking like one of the best days so far. Fingers crossed. That's the Tournette up there. That's the start of the Aravi over there. Can't remember the name of that one. And this is Point de Sambuy, or La Sambuy. Our plan is to take off, go around that little rock there, onto the face of there. Seems to be working, humorous there. Onto the Aravi, down to the far end of the Aravi, onto Veran, into the Chamonix Valley, along the Chamonix Valley at 3,000 meters, hop over to Verbier at the end, cruise along the south side of the Sion Valley, or maybe the north, we'll have to see. Anyway, wish us luck. No! Just beautiful up here. It's Albertville down there. So Rich and Marcin have taken off. I'll wait for them over here. Will, Rich and Mincek down below. Let's get the camera out again. Super nice smooth climb here. 2.5, sometimes 3. Come on guys, don't mince around. Good strong climb here, 3 meters per second. Five. And next up, the Aravi. Just fantastic. Cold at our pets. Should land for coffee, let the others catch up. Really lovely thermal here, back up at 2.2. Hold the Clusaz. Nine. Getting towards the end of the Aravi. There were a couple of other gliders, both got sucked up into the cloud. Pretty strong lift. But I can pretty much head for Veran now if I wanted to. But I'll just go along this cloud a bit further. Joined by an Enzo 3. He's going south, I'm going north. Very pretty coloured wing. I'll just work this for a seat until I see if the Enzo finds anything. Okay guys, I'm at the end of the Aravi on that little, on the bump
just before the end, and I'm at 2750 and going for the transition. Over Salange towards Varane. Good opportunity to put my inner gloves on because my hands are getting cold. Also a little snack.
Just enjoying the views.
Mont Blanc looking spectacular. So I've easily made it across. Lost about 700 metres though, down at just over 2,000. But that's plenty of height. So I got the plongeau takeoff down there. Yeah, down there. This is so much easier than last time I came across here, a year ago. Okay, let's turn. I really need to. Bonjour. Light winds, just great conditions. Up at 2.5, the base must be 3 here, I should think, close to. About 3,000 metres, cruising past Chamonix down there. Really lovely conditions. Up the Mer de Glace. Not exactly much glass up there, except right at the top. This is the Agui Rouge, for obvious reasons. And there is Switzerland. Find a faster climb. Under this cloud there'll be a faster climb. Where that glider is. Funny old thing that. I'm at 2.6. Decision time, north side of the valley or south side. I quite fancy the south side. Just need to get some height there. There hasn't been any good strong thermals for a while. Pretty sweet view of the lake. It's a tight little bugger! 24. I need to get high on this one. Behind me, and I'm now heading for the main ridge. I'm up at 2350, still going up. Nice climb from down there, that little village, and these spurs a bit more into wind, so pretty nice really. Oh, there's people out there. Base is super high, so if I can get high, who knows. Well, I'm up at 2.6, but I've gained 1,000 meters, which is very nice to have in the bank. I think that's Verbier, I'm not entirely sure. Lovely area though. I'm hoping this climb will take me all the way to base. Slow down a bit. Well, this is pretty special. Up at 3.1. Just a huge panorama of mountains. Amazing. Look at that. Rich and Mincek are safe on the ground down near Sion. Just spectacular. It's 3,500 feet now. Pretty spectacular. Down there, that's what I'm heading for. And I think that's the Wieshorn up to my right. Matterhorn, I think, is there in the cloud. I think that's the Matterhorn. I Zermatt up there. I remember driving up there last summer. A bit rock and roll just at the moment. A bit more wind high up. I want to get up high here and then try and cross the valley, I think. Straight line. Oh, sorry, 3,000 metres. Really nice climb. It's a little lake there, some grassy patches. I think I might camp over here. The thing is, I'm going up, I want to go down. Fantastic flight. I've made it to just near Feite takeoff, which is just over that little hill there, just a short walk. I just fancied it here because there's a lake up there, a bar. What a flight, 6.5 hours, about 175k. Stunning scenery, absolutely amazing. Yeah, brilliant, what fun. Well, I found what's almost the perfect spot. views of the mountains, facing southeasterly for the morning, a lake for a morning swim. Only trouble is, well, you can probably hear the cowbells. I'm not sure if those are bulls or not, I can't. Yeah, they're bulls. I'm not sure it's sensible to camp in the middle of cows and bulls. So I shall have to find somewhere else. That is a shame. Never mind. Mincek, start us off.
Yeah, I've got macaroni trees. It's quite good.
It's quite good?
Yeah.
How did you describe it as earlier? Or maybe you don't want to...
It did look like a sick, but yeah, it tastes like macaroni cheese.
Tastes so, all right.
Yeah.
Excellent, good. Out of 10?
8.
8 out of 10. Good. Richard, what have you got?
I have same company, Summit to Eat. I only bought it because of the name.
Summit to Eat.
Summit to Eat, yep.
Boom, boom, love it.
Yep, and it's a pasta bolognese, and... It looks like a pasta bolognese and it tastes good. I'd probably give this one 8.5 maybe.
8.5?
Yeah, I've got to give it a little bit of room.
Little bit?
Yeah. So
okay, so that's good. Two successes for Summit to Eat.
What about yours then, Tim? What have you got?
Okay, so I've got adventure food. Satay babi. I don't know if that means it's got chopped up babi, bambinos in it or anything, but...
Baby.
Yeah, I've had two pasta ones, which quite honestly... tasted identical. That was the pasta carbonara and the pasta al funghi. But this is really nice. Very nice rice dish, as you can see.
Looks like food.
Looks like food. Looks like rice.
What's the rating?
Yeah, I'll rate it higher than the pasta. I'll give it... I didn't rate the pasta, actually. I mean, I did rate... I liked it, but I didn't physically rate it. Yeah, we'll give it 9 out of 10.
Oh, yes, look at that.
Well done, adventure food.
Tonight's a winner.